VideoProc Converter, a multimedia tool that is up to convert, download, record, and perform simple edits to enhance video, music, and DVDs. With VideoProc Converter, you can convert your DVD into digital content. You can digitize your DVD, okay, to convert it into various formats, different types of format, from MP4 to any kind of format of your choice. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you the very basic step-by-step process on how to access your DVD content and convert it using VideoProc Converter into different formats for your usage for storage, because it's now possible that we've converted or we've changed from the usual DVD drive or DVD disc. So the first thing you need to do is to take your CD, okay, something like this, and then insert it into your computer. And once you insert it, you can go ahead and come to the website, or you can open your browser and come to the search bar and just search for Google to bring you over here. And you can just go ahead and search for VideoProc, just like so, and hit on enter, and it's going to bring you over here. So the first one is VideoProc, a one-stop video processing software. You just click on it. Alternatively, you can just go ahead and come to videoproc.com, and it's going to bring you over here. So this is the one-stop video processing software that converts, resize, and do all sort of conversions in your media from DVD to other formats, or from converting video clips or audio clips into different formats of your choice. And you can use their downloader or the recorder as well to record your screen and your face during any kind of tutorial that you may have. Now, for quick access, main focus for today is the VideoProc Converter. And for quick access, you can come to the download center over here by just clicking on download center, and it will bring you over here. So you can see download VideoProc Converter, and the best part of it is that it's available for Windows operating system and Mac operating system as well. So all you need is just to click on this to download. The installation process is just click through. It doesn't take any time, it's just step by step. Just follow the process and you get it installed. Okay, so let's say I've installed mine. You can come to the launch pad over here and just launch it. So you can see it over here, VideoProc Converter. So you just click on it, and you can see the different kind of formats or different kind of functions that it can do. It can work with DVD. For my own case, I'm dealing with DVD, so I'm just going to select DVD directly, and it's going to bring you to this very platform where you have to drag the file. There are three steps over here. The first one is to drag the file, or you can click on this to navigate to wherever you have your DVD saved, and you can import it and do the conversion as you so wish. But then generally, you can see this, we can deal with DVD disc, or you can open a folder, or you can open an ISO file and go ahead with the conversion of different formats. So the formats you can convert are down here. Okay, you can see these are the popular ones: MP4, H.264 for iPhone, for Android, and MP4 HEVC. These are different formats that are very popular. And then you can see the video formats. There are different formats that you can easily convert your videos to. Okay, depending on the device as well, you can check based on device, based on backup. You can see you can have ISO, video TS, MKV files formats, or H.264 MKV format. You can see different kind of formats over here, and you can have different music formats. So they are just basically three steps. The first one is to drag and drop the DVD file, just drag it and drop it here. And the second step is to choose one target format that you are interested in converting, and then you can click on run to convert that format, that particular section of the video that you've selected. So let's say we are going with this. So this is my DVD. I can just select, I've inserted this DVD drive, DVD disc into the DVD drive. I can just drag and drop this directly here, and you can see it is analyzing and processing it. You just process it pretty fast, and this is the content. This is what is inside. Okay, the disk. You can see this is a H.264 format. Okay, and this is the main name of the disk, and there are some information. If you require the information, this is the information. This is how much time everything is going to. It's about 11 hours disk, and you can see the chapters by coming over here. You can see there are different kind of chapters, because this is a series movie, okay, that contains different kind of chapters. So you can even do your conversion according to the chapters that you are interested. Now, these are some of the properties of the DVD. Okay, so to start your editing, all you need is to come over here and click on edit. Okay, once you click on edit, you'll be brought into this very platform. So let me explain what this platform does. For example, this is the original view of the video. I've just paused it. If I allow it, it will play automatic. This is the original view. Okay, whatever touch, whatever edits you make, it's going to affect and you to preview it on the preview windows. Okay, on the preview canvas over here. So this is the total length of the video, 11 hours, 10 minutes, 26 seconds. And so you can have different kind of tabs, for example, the audio and video format. Over here, you can rotate the video left, right. And once you do the rotation, you can see the effect on the right hand side, which is the preview panel or the preview canvas. You can rotate right as well if you're interested, and you can see depending on what angle you are targeting. This is 90 degrees, this is 180, and this is 270, and then this is zero. So let's keep it at zero for now. And you can do vertical flipping of the video as well. You can flip vertical like this, you can flip vertical backward, or you can flip horizontal if you want, and you can flip back horizontal as well if you want. So it depends on you, how do you want to edit the video. So these are the playback speed. If you intend to speed up the clip, you can just make it maybe times 2 and it's going to run faster, 100% faster, or you can make it times 4 or thereabout. So you are free to just go ahead and extend the playback speed accordingly, but for this tutorial I want to just keep it at 1 because I'm not interested in speeding up anything. Okay, you can recalculate the timestamp, and over here is the audio properties. You can increase the volume. Right now it's at 100%. You can take it to 200%, which is going to be too loud, and you can bring it back to 100 if you're interested. And then this is the audio delay time. I don't touch anything here during any conversion. And if you want to disable all the tracks, all the audio tracks, you can do that from here by just enabling this. And alternatively, you can reset everything back to default by clicking on this only, and it's going to go back to the default. Now the next thing is we look at the effects. Effects can give you different kind of looks in your video. You can see the different effects that we have. You can select negate, and even though you are not going to see the preview on the preview panel, it's after you've done the processing and you've run the video, that's when you see the impact. Okay, you can reduce noise if there is noise, you can do full color if you're interested, or you can come down and do painting depending on your choice. So you can choose from the range of different kind of effects that we have over here. So if you're interested, you can come over here also and play around with the brightness. Okay, so you can see as you are increasing or decreasing the brightness, it is showing in the preview. And the contrast as well, we can play around with the contrast. You can make it high contrast or low contrast. You can edit as you so wish. You can increase or decrease the saturation and play around with the hue. Very important. You can see you can just play around with it, and you can play around with the gamma effect as well to give it another finishing touch. So you can just try to move across to see some of the areas that we're interested. Okay, so you can see the little change that we've made from the original clip. So if you are not certain and you don't want the changes you've made, you can always reset it to the default setting by just coming here. You can reset it, and this grayscale is not going to take effect, like I said, until you have output the video, until you have converted the video. Now the next thing is subtitles. You have different kind of subtitles. You can add subtitles from a file. You can just click on this to navigate to wherever you have the subtitle, and you can bring it in, or you can search the subtitle directly by just clicking. It will open within your system where you have the subtitle, and you can easily navigate and bring it in. Now the next thing is the cut, which is very, very important. I count this as one of the most important feature of this very DVD converter. You can navigate across. The step one is to drag the knobs, okay, from one end to another. You can drag the two. Assuming I'm interested in only this portion of the video, I can just select up to this portion. Okay, so you can see once you specify the areas you need, you can just come over to the right hand side and click on cut, and it's going to add that particular clip to the list. Okay, it's going to add it to the list, and you are free to edit as well if you're interested in editing. You can click to edit, and you can change the timing, whether you want to increase the timing or you want to decrease the timing as well from here. It will just help you to change the timing and edit. And once you're done, you can click on done, and it's now part of the clips that you're going to export. You can take in another place as well. You may decide to move in and select another location. Okay, assuming I want to select this location, and I can just come over here and click on cut, and it's going to cut that particular location, and it's going to add it to the list of the clips that I have and I'm interested in using. Okay, so this is about cut. Now we have crop. Cropping enables you to crop the video from the original. So you can see enable cropping. Now you have the option to crop from all angle. Okay, assuming I want to remove this black sign, I can just come over to the top here and just drag gradually here and drag this one also. So we just have it covered, and this is the only portion that is going to show on this video once it is processed. Now this is the, once you enable the cropping, these are the features or the numbers that have just, the positions that have just been defined based on my manual movement of the clip and the border. Okay, so you can see this is 76. If you want, you can increase, and you can see it is affecting at the top. This is the top and this is the bottom. If you want to increase as well, you can see manually you can do that and increase or decrease. Now this is the default size that you have after the cropping. Okay, so you can go ahead and follow the process and enable the expanded bars to be placed side by side of your video if you're interested, by just clicking on this. Now the next one, which is one of the most important, is watermark. If you're interested in adding watermark to your video, this is the opportunity. It can come in two forms, either a text. Okay, you can select to enable watermark, even either in the form of text. You can select and just write whatever you want to write. For example, and you want to write confidential, and I say confidential, and I can play around with the position. I can manually select, drag and move it to any position, and I can manually increase the sizing to make it a bit bigger and to cover the areas that I'm interested, at least to show that this is confidential, it's not yet in public for usage. And you can play around with the transparency and make it a bit washed out, okay, so it doesn't look so glaring and it doesn't obstruct anything from the movie. And you can play around with the position over here manually. You can play around with the position, you can move it to the left and backward, or to the top and backward. You can do all that from here. Okay, so it's all bows down to you how, which one you want to play around with. And the width also, you can increase the width and height, you can play with it. And in case if you don't want to use a text, you want to use an image, you can go ahead and select over here and you can add an image. You can select and you can select any image of your choice. Okay, let's say I'm selecting this image. You can just select it and bring it in, and you can just easily on your own navigate and place it wherever you want to place it. Okay, and you can manually also extend the size or reduce the size accordingly and place it wherever you want. Or if you want a time code, you can as well add the time code, and you can play around with the coloration of that time code. You can play around with the font type, okay, and the color. You can put in different color, like you can see now the coloration, and you can play around with the sizing as well from here. Alternatively, you can increase the opacity, so you can see now clearly the time code. In cases of the text also, you have the option over here to play around and play around with the font style and font sizes. Okay, the coloration, you can play around with the color, whatever you want, you can put in the color, and the sizing as well, you can play around with the sizing if you're interested in playing around with the sizing. So you can see we can just drag and drop on our own. So once you're done, this is all. If you are done with this much of editing and you like what you see, you want to output this, all you need is to say done, and you've selected this. So down here you can select which format do you want to convert. So you can come to popular. In my own case, I want to convert to mp4, so I can just select mp4 and I can just come over here and say run, and it's going to run and convert the selected clip that I have selected through the editing process into mp4. Okay, so you can see the process of the conversion. It's just going to take in 5 minutes for the free version, and if you are a paid user, then it's just going to take 5 minutes. And if you want to extend beyond 5 minutes, then you have to pay. I put a link in the description so you can follow through and register, and then you can make use of it. So ladies and gentlemen, this is just a bit about how to use the VideoProc DVD converter to convert or to digitize your video content, or to convert your video into different formats. Like you've seen, this one now has been converted into MP4 from the little clips that we've done, and this is just 5 minutes for our own consumption and just for the benefits of this tutorial. So ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Please don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons to stay connected with this channel for more and more videos like this. So I'll see you in my next video. Bye.